Welcome to In Depth. I'm Teena Jha. The Congress and six other opposition parties met Vice President and Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu on Friday, seeking impeachment of Chief Justice of India, Dipak Misra. Signed by 64 Rajya Sabha MPs, the notice accuses the Chief Justice of five counts of misbehavior and also misusing authority. So what is impeachment? Now, the Constitution itself does not use the word impeachment. It's a colloquial term that refers to the proceedings under Article 124 to remove a Supreme Court judge and Article 218 to remove a High Court judge. This is the process by which a judge can be removed by an order of the President of India. We look at this process in depth today, examining who can be impeached, the grounds on which they can be impeached, the grounds that have been cited to seek the impeachment of the current Chief Justice of India, and how does the process work in other parts of the world. So with the notice being handed over to the Vice President and Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu, he will now ascertain whether the case made out in the notice merits moving such a motion.
In move unprecedented in Indian history, the Congress and six other opposition parties have moved an impeachment motion against Chief Justice of India, Dipak Misra. Accusing him of five counts of misbehavior, the opposition parties met Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu and handed over a notice for the impeachment under Section 124 of the Constitution. 64 MPs of the Upper House signed the notice. They included MPs from Congress, NCP, CPIM and CPI, SP, BSP and the Indian Union Muslim League.
The more dangerous part is the timing of this motion. The timing of the motion is one day after the Loya judgment. And the Loya judgment, Supreme Court has said that it is a politically motivated case. So if a politically motivated case is decided one way, that means against a political party or against the views of a particular group of political parties, then you start an impeachment case against the judge. And just by signing of 50 MPs, you can start the process. So it's actually a misuse of the process of impeachment, if you were to ask me.
The impeachment notice comes a day after the Supreme Court rejected a petition seeking an independent probe into the death of Judge P.H. Loya. Chief Justice of India, Dipak Misra, headed the bench that dismissed the petition, saying frivolous petitions pose a grave danger to the credibility of the judicial process. After the order, the Congress held a discussion with the opposition parties in the Parliament to move the impeachment motion against the Chief Justice. Congress said many questions related to Justice Loya's death remain unanswered.
We have sought his removal under Article 217, read with Article 124, bracket 4. Of the Constitution of India.
Finance Minister and leader of Rajya Sabha, Arun Jaitley, denounced the opposition's move in an article on the Facebook. Jaitley said, and I quote, "The Congress party and its friends have started using impeachment as a political tool to use the power as intimidatory tactics when neither you have a case of proven misconduct or the numbers on your side is a serious threat to the judicial independence. It is a revenge petition after the falsehood of the Congress party has been established in the Justice Loya death case."
On that, they want to put pressure on the judiciary that either you act according to us, and if you choose not to act according to us, then we will bring impeachment against you. And this is exactly what is the methodology adopted by the Congress party.
The five allegations listed in the impeachment notice include an alleged bribery scandal involving Lucknow-based Prasad Education Trust that ran a medical college. The opposition questioned the manner in which the case was dealt by the CJI. The second charge is about the Chief Justice dealing with a writ petition on both the administrative and the judicial side that sought an investigation into the matter of Prasad Education Trust. The third charge related to Justice Chalameshwar's letter that said the case allotment was antedated. The fourth charge is of a land grab. The opposition claims that the Chief Justice acquired land when he was an advocate by giving a false affidavit. The fifth charge relates to abuse of exercise of power. The opposition claims he misused his authority as master of the roster by choosing to send sensitive matters to particular benches. The debate for the impeachment of Chief Justice started on 12th January, when four senior judges of the Supreme Court held a press conference alleging irregularities in the functioning of the Apex Court. The judges also raised concerns over the death of Justice Lawyer. Meanwhile, the Supreme Court expressed displeasure over public discussion on the impeachment issue. The Apex Court said public statements, including some made by the lawmakers on impeachment of judges, are very unfortunate. The Apex Court has also sought Attorney General's assistance to deal with the PIL that seeks restrictions on the media in reporting the impeachment matter. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
So impeachment is the process by which a legislative body formally levels charges against a high official of the government for violating the constitution. Let's learn what are the provisions in the constitution about impeachment and how does the process of impeachment occur.
Impeachment is a judicial process by which a legislative body formally levels charges against a high official of government for violating the constitution. It is done by parliament and involves high officials, the president, chief justice of high court and supreme court, and the election commissioner of India. Article 56 of the Indian Constitution says that the president may, for violation of the constitution, be removed from office by impeachment before the expiry of the term. Article 61 explains the procedure for impeachment of the president. Under this, when a president is to be impeached, the charge shall be preferred by either House of Parliament. However, Article 124, 4 of Constitution of India lays down the procedure for removal of a judge of Supreme Court and High Court that is applicable to the Chief Justice as well. A judge can be removed only through a process of impeachment on the grounds of misconduct and inability.
Impeachment motion can be moved against a judge of the High Court or the Supreme Court, all Chief Justice of the High Court and Chief Justice of the Supreme Court, on two grounds: proved misbehavior and incompetence, incapacity. Proved misbehavior and incapacity. Incapacity can be physical incapacity or mental incapacity.
The Constitution provides that a judge can be removed only by a presidential order based on a motion passed by both Houses of Parliament. The procedure to remove judges is elaborated in the Judges Inquiry Act 1968. The Act sets out the following steps. It says an impeachment motion may originate in either House of Parliament. At least 100 members of Lok Sabha or at least 50 members of Rajya Sabha may give a notice of the motion to Speaker or Chairman. The Speaker or Chairman may then consult individuals and examine relevant material. Based on this, they may refuse or accept the motion. If the motion is admitted, a three-member committee has to be constituted to investigate the complaint. Committee will have a Supreme Court judge, Chief Justice of a High Court, and a distinguished jurist. The committee will frame charges on which the investigation will be conducted. A copy of the charges will be forwarded to the judge, who can present a written defense. After investigation, the committee's report is to be put forth before the relevant house by Speaker or Chairman. If the committee finds the judge guilty, the motion for removal will be taken up for consideration and debated. The motion for removal is required to be adopted by each House of Parliament by a majority of the total membership of that house, or a majority of at least two-thirds of the members of that House present and voting. If the motion is adopted by this majority, the motion will be sent to the other House for adoption. Once the motion is adopted in both Houses, it is sent to the President, who will then issue an order for the removal of the judge.
The impeachment will be preceded by an inquiry under the Judges Inquiry Act. So when the motion is moved before the Rajya Sabha, it can be by 50 MPs. If it is in the Lok Sabha, it has to be by 100 MPs. And after the 50 MPs move the chairman of the Rajya Sabha, then the chairman can consult anybody he feels appropriate. So he could be a legal luminary, he could be an eminent legal person, he could be the attorney general, anybody he feels he wants to consult. And after that consultation, He can reject the motion at that stage. If he were to, supposing, accept the motion, then a 3-judge inquiry will be constituted, consisting of a Supreme Court judge, a High Court judge, and an eminent jurist, and they will then inquire the matter.
Majority of the members present and voting, a majority of the total membership of the House, and 2/3 of the members present and voting. That is the condition. That is a special majority which is normally required for an amendment of the Constitution and all that. So that special majority is required for impeachment. So if the motion secures this majority, special majority, then the House will go to the other House. Suppose it takes place in the Rajya Sabha, it will go to the Lok Sabha. There also the special majority is required for passing this motion. After it is passed, then each House will send an address to the President.
But before the process of impeachment starts, the person against whom the motion has been taken up can present his side of version before the House. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha Television.
Time for a short break on the program. We'll be right back.
Tales that inspire. Stories of social change. A salute to diversity. Promoting public discourse. Events that motivate. Inspiring the innovative spirit. Watch Rajya Sabha Television documentaries.
Malik, the first Indian woman to win a silver medal at the 2016 Paralympic Games. Paralyzed from the waist down and the mother of two daughters, Deepa Malik went on to set records for biking and swimming.
In any sport, Deepa Malik picks up the silver. From New Delhi, silver medalist in the javelin at the 2014 Asian Games.
Turning her disability into a challenge, Deepa rode the first bike adapted for paraplegics, swam a kilometre against the current in Yamuna, drove 3,000 kilometres to Leh and back through high altitude passes. Deepa, who has raised the bar for every person, has gone to prove that she is more able than her critics. She has been honoured with the First Lady Award by the President of India in 2018.
As on today, the inland fisheries contribute 65% of the fish production of India. So we are one of the propagating the inland sectors, the productivity enhancement, which is we are looking with the state governments. We have categorized 100 nutri-fish index. If you take this fish, then instead of taking the capsules for the micronutrient vitamins, and you can reduce that thing.
Watch Eureka with Dr. B.K. Das, Director, ICAR, Central Inland Fisheries Research Institute, Kolkata, at Saturday 4 p.m. and Sunday 12 noon, only on Rajya Sabha Television.
Mihir Sen, an outstanding and extraordinary saltwater swimmer of India. He's the first Asian to swim the English Channel way back in 1958. And just 8 years later,
In 1966, he swam the seven seas of the five continents in one calendar year, which etched his name in the Guinness Book of World Records. In 1959, he was also conferred the Padma Shri, and in 1967, he was awarded the Padma Bhushan.
शो हुआ तो लोगों ने आकर मुझसे पूछा आप राही साहब को कितनी अच्छी तरह जानते थे। मैंने कहा कि मैंने राही साहब को कभी देखा ही नहीं और सिवाय एक फोटोग्राफ के मैं राही साहब को जानता नहीं।
आदरणीय अल्लाह मियां और श्री रामचंद्र जी की सेवा में राही मासूम रजा का सादर प्रणाम।
एक्टिंग इज नॉट अबाउट wearing dark glasses or wearing a jacket and holding a cigarette in your hand and a gun and saying dialogues. It's about knowing yourself first.
एमएलए रवि के क्लब में तुमने किसी को मारा था?
जॉनी को।
जॉनी, जॉनी, जॉनी,
जॉ। नमस्कार हूँ, मैं विनय वर्मा। प्रोग्राम गुफ्तगुलों नन्नो कलवंडी।
सिर्फ राज्यसभा टीवी पर।
Welcome back. You're watching In Depth on the impeachment process. Let's now look into how many judges have had to face impeachment motions in the country in the past.
The process to remove important persons from constitutional posts is a cumbersome process. It is intended to be complex so as to allow these important people to do their job without fear. However, if any of them is found involved in a misconduct or violation of constitution, they can be impeached. Current Justice Dipak Misra is the first Supreme Court Chief Justice against whom an impeachment motion has been brought. The removal of Chief Justice of the High Court is similar. There have been instances where the impeachment motion has been brought against many chief justices.
Inquiry will be constituted consisting of a Supreme Court judge, a High Court judge and an eminent jurist, and they will then inquire the matter. And after that inquiry, again, if he is found not guilty, then the matter can close at that stage also. If he is found guilty in that inquiry, then the matter goes to the houses, and both the houses have to vote by a majority of the total house and two-thirds of the members present in voting.
Justice V. Ramaswamy was the first judge against whom impeachment proceedings were initiated when he was a sitting judge of the Supreme Court. Before this, he was the Chief Justice of the Punjab and Haryana High Court. In 1991, serious charges of corruption were levelled against him. Apart from this, there was also an issue of discrepancy in his appointment. In 1993, an impeachment motion was brought in the Lok Sabha, but due to absence of two-thirds majority, it couldn't be passed. However, Justice V. Ramaswamy later resigned from his post.
In the case of Mr. Ramaswamy, Justice Ramaswamy, Ramaswamy himself did not appear. And of course, he protested against the whole proceedings, right from the formation of the committee and so on. But in that case, the committee found him guilty of corruption. That is why it came to Parliament. That was the final stage. And then the lawyer appeared on his behalf. So the proceedings went on for three or four hours. After that, when it was voted, put to vote, it did not secure the majority.
V. Ramaswamy going up to the voting in the House, which failed. I don't remember any other judge's impeachment going up to the House, but there are instances where judges have faced the inquiry, like there is a judge, Madhya Pradesh judge, whose inquiry is pending. And there are some cases where when the impeachment motion was moved, at that stage only people resigned. So,
Justice P. D. Dinakaran was the Chief Justice of the Sikkim High Court. In 2009, Rajya Sabha MPs wrote a letter to then Vice President Mohammed Hamid Ansari and levelled 16 charges against him, after which there was a process of bringing an impeachment motion against him. Then Rajya Sabha Chairman Ansari set up a three-member committee to look into the allegations. But a few days before the hearing, Justice Dinakaran resigned from his post. Justice Soumitra Sen of the Calcutta High Court was the second judge to face an impeachment motion. In 2011, he faced a charge of misconduct, after which an impeachment motion was brought against Justice Sen in the Rajya Sabha. The upper house passed the motion, which then went to the Lok Sabha, and just before the voting, Justice Sen resigned. In 2015, 58 Rajya Sabha MPs moved an impeachment notice against Justice J.B. Pardiwala of the Gujarat High Court for his objectionable remarks on the issue of reservation. Just before then Chairman Muhammad Hamid Ansari was about to take a decision on it, Justice Pardiwala resigned, after which the impeachment motion against him was also taken back. In 2015, Rajya Sabha MPs were about to bring an impeachment motion against Madhya Pradesh High Court Justice S.K. Gangil, but allegations of sexual harassment against him were not proved during the investigation. Apart from this, efforts were made to bring impeachment motion twice in 2016 and 17 against Justice C.V. Nagarjun Reddy of Andhra Pradesh Telangana High Court, but these proposals never received concrete support. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And now let's talk a little about the history of impeachment. It is a process that started in the United Kingdom. Today it is present in almost every country. But cases of removing people who are occupying high constitutional posts through impeachment are very rare.
The word impeachment comes from the Latin word impedicere, that expresses the idea of becoming caught or entrapped. But it is the British who are believed to have introduced it in the legal process. In Egypt, impeachment was a provision in the latter half of the 14th century. There are many instances of impeachment in Indian history, but some of the most discussed cases are that of the first British Governor-General of Bengal, Warren Hastings. Warren Hastings was accused of misconduct and corruption during his time in Calcutta. The case dragged on from 1788 to 1795, and he was eventually acquitted. First Viscount Melville was the last person to be impeached in the United Kingdom for misappropriation of public money. Although acquitted, he never held public office again. In the US, the President, Vice President, and all civil officers can be removed from office on impeachment for treason, bribery, or other high crimes and misdemeanors. However, the impeachment process in the US varies from one state to the other. In 1913, Governor of New York William Sulzer was impeached on charges that he falsified his sworn statement of campaign expenditures. Impeachment proceedings have been initiated against several presidents of the United States. These include John Taylor in 1843, Andrew Johnson in 1868, Richard Nixon in 1974, and Bill Clinton in 1998. However, Andrew Johnson and Bill Clinton are the only two presidents to have been successfully impeached by the House of Representatives.
Well, there are many countries in the world have this provision where the parliament has been given the power to impeach a judge. In UK, USA, Canada, in all these countries you have these provisions. But in those countries, you know, there is an additional provision. That is an in-house procedure for dealing with and a delinquent judge, and he is given a lesser punishment. Lesser punishment means he will not be assigned cases and he will be kept waiting. That kind of punishment.
Let's talk about the most recent cases in other countries of the world. In 1992, then Brazilian President Fernando Afonso Collor de Mello was removed from presidency after the Brazilian Senate found him guilty on charges of corruption. In 2000, then President of Peru Alberto Fujimori was also removed from the office and sentenced to life imprisonment. The first European head of the state to be impeached was former Lithuanian President Ronaldas Paksas. He was removed from office in 2004 after it emerged that he was granted citizenship to a major campaign donor. In 2012, Paraguay's President Fernando Lugo was removed from office on charges of treason. And in 2017, South Korean President Park Geun-hye was removed from office following impeachment process after being found guilty of abuse of power and coercion. According to Article 56 of the Indian Constitution, only the President can be impeached on the basis of violation of the Constitution. However, due to a strong and clean democratic process, no Indian President has faced impeachment proceedings till date. ब्यूरो रिपोर्ट, राज्यसभा टीवी।
And that's it from us in this edition of In Depth. We'll be back with another issue same time on Monday. Thanks for watching.